Thanks once again for dropping by the channel. If you like the content, if you're new to the channel, please hit subscribe, share the video if you enjoyed it, felt it was useful. Now let's get into this. So, what's next? I haven't talked about a fighter, well, I haven't talked about any real fighter about these in a while. I think the last one I done was, I think it was Chris Eubank, the last one I done. So we're going to talk about a fighter who, refreshingly, is coming out and saying kind of things you want to hear, well, I suppose you don't want to necessarily hear it, but you want to hear it in a sense of, he's admitting to his past mistakes, which is Errol Spence. Now, Errol Spence, there's a boxing scene article here where he says rematch with Porter has to wait to these bigger fish to fry. He's naming Manny Pacquiao and Terence Crawford as potential opponents. Obviously, when boxing resumes and we get some of these big fights made, can't see Errol Spence or any of the top welterweights really, truth be told, having a fight this year just based on what's going on. But earlier on in the week, I think Errol Spence came out and kind of, he almost said that car crash, the car accident he was in, put everything in context. You know, the crash kind of woke him up because he'd gone from being a fighter who was a hard-working fighter, and I mean in and out of the ring, you know, he was just, you know, a real blue-collar kind of fighter. And then he went and started hanging around with the Charlos, started hanging around with Gervonta Davis, Adrian Broner, these idiots. And, you know, he just came a classic PBC, you know, what do you call them? You know, just guys who are just idiots. And, like, that's not to knock them as fighters, but that's what they are. They're just idiots. They just don't give a shit. And Errol Spence was going down that path. Now, I hope he is serious when he says that, you know, it's put everything in content and, you know, he's not going to do something so stupid again. Because, you know, he turned at the press conferences drunk, you know, blown up in between fights, which he never did before. You know, he didn't do that before. He used to, you know, criticise Kell Brook for doing that, and then he goes around and does it himself. You know, and obviously the drink driving is, you know, the icing on the cake. It's a monumentally stupid thing to do, drink driving anyway, but to be doing it and then, you know, crashing badly and being, you know, flung from a car at high speeds, I mean, if that's not going to wake you up, then nothing's going to wake you up. You know, Errol Spence, I've said it once, I'll say it again, I don't buy that he doesn't have residual injuries, you know, worse injuries than were reported. We know he's two false teeth, which I believe he's getting replaced, or he's getting the real ones put in. But I just can't comprehend, having seen the crash, seeing how violent it was, that maybe, I don't know if it's healed or not, but there has to have been other injuries there. You know, I just don't buy that it was just his teeth and a few little scratches here and there, and it was, you know, all well and good. You flung violently from a Ferrari at high speed. I just don't buy it, you know. Now saying that, if he did have residual injuries, they're obviously, so we know, they're probably not gonna, you know, damage his career in the sense that he can never box again. But the damage he's done to his body, you know, with the alcohol, you know, with the blowing up in between fights, and obviously the crash, is that gonna take away from his prime? You know, are we ever gonna see the best of Errol Spence? You know, that's the question. Jury's still out on me. It will take seeing him back in the ring. Now, he'd said, I think was it coming up to Christmas last year or January this year, that he wanted to fight this summer against Danny Garcia. I seriously doubt that will happen. Well, it's not going to happen this summer, but his return fight against Danny Garcia, can't see that happening at all. I think they'll take a soft touch. They'll probably take a Lipinets or someone like that. It will really depend on how Spence looks in kind of that fight, that we'll see how he's going. Like, he's naming Manny Pacquiao and, you know, Terence Crawford. I would have loved to have seen the Terence Crawford fight, you know, if we're talking about a peak Spence, because we don't know if we have that. So, would the Crawford fight interest me now? It's refreshing to hear a PBC fighter mention Terence Crawford now, to be honest with you, because whenever you hear, you know, Danny Garcia interviewed or, you know, a PBC fighter, you know, they're naming all the top welterweights except Terence Crawford. You know, they don't mention him, so it's just refreshing to hear a PBC fighter mention Terence Crawford now at this stage, because most of them don't. You know, he's been shamelessly frozen out. You know, the WBO or PBC don't rate the WBO as a legit title anymore, which is absurd, because Andy Ruiz had that title, and if you don't rate it, why are you paying sanction fees? You know, why don't you just vacate it if it's not worth it, you know? paying sanctioning fees to a title you don't think is worth it, okay? You don't think is legit, okay? Fair enough. So yeah, Errol Spence, when he does come back, which I reckon it'll be next year, you know, and I actually think that this lockdown, although it's absolute, you know what, it will probably do him the world of good, because it will give him time to be with his family, you know, give him time to maybe get his head cleaned. You know, he's not going to be able to go to these press conferences and get drunk and see the Charlos and, you know, this, that and the other. And I think that it will delay his comeback, which I think is a good thing, because if he was hell-bent on fighting in 2020, that could be too soon. You know, I keep saying, people, go and look at the video of that car accident. And I said, accident. Accident implies there's no one to blame. Yeah, there was someone to blame. So it was called a car crash. Go look at that car crash. It was bad. It was bad. So if you're going to rush someone coming back after a traumatic experience like that, you're not going to see the best out of them. So maybe 2021 is the perfect time for Errol Spence to come back. But we'll have to see how he looks in his comeback fight. You know, I think it would not be a very good idea to put him in there against a top welterweight, as in an elite top welterweight. You know, as I said, Sergey Lipinets or someone like that. You know, that there's no issue there. I think Robert Garcia has come back over the last year. Maybe someone like that who's, you know, over the hill. Who's over the hill a couple of years ago, someone like that. We just see how Spence is. Get a gauge of where Spence is at, as opposed to sticking him in there with a Manny Pacquiao or a Terence Crawford or even a Sean Porter. Because I don't think that would be a very good idea. I think that would be a very, very silly idea to do that. We need to see what he's like first before we can say, okay, this is the Spence who fought Sean Porter. He's going to be fine. Or we could look at Spence and say, you know what, this Spence is not the Spence who fought Sean Porter. There's problems there. So, you know, those are my thoughts on this. In terms of what's next for him, like I said, we don't know what's going on with boxing. When we're going to be back, you know, Spence is actually, I've seen articles where it said he's willing to fight behind closed doors. We just need to wait and see when boxing comes back. But I definitely think we won't be seeing Spence in there against an elite welterweight. Might see him in there against a world level, fringe world level welterweight, but in terms of an elite welterweight in his first fight back, I ain't seeing that at all. You know, that I think that's unrealistic. You know, I could be proven wrong, but I think that's unrealistic to see him in there against a top elite welterweight like a Manny Pacquiao. Danny Garcia wouldn't class him as an elite welterweight. World level, yeah, elite, no. But probably still too high a level to be taking that risk with coming back from a serious crash like that. So, now those are my thoughts on this. Let me know yours down below. Who would you like to see him fight when he comes back? Let me know yours down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, of course, if you are new. And as always, I will talk to you. So before I go, I just want to say thank you for dropping by the channel. I really do appreciate it. I mean, all the support, all the things that have happened on this channel over the last year have been incredible. If you're new to the channel, as you'll see on screen there's a couple of like older videos that I have. Some of them aren't really relevant now, to be fair, but some of them are, like my Fighters with a Problem series, stuff like that. If you like any of this, please subscribe. Like the video you just watched, share it, do it, all you got to do. Let's try and keep this channel going, because I love doing this and I love interacting with the fans, and I love hopefully the fans love watching my videos. So thank you for dropping by. I've been G-Man. I will talk to you.